My name is Javier Sosa. I'm the color guard director here at Damonte Ranch High School. Been here for 6 years running the program. My position usually coincides with the band director, more from an artistic standpoint, and program coordination is my role as it relates to the team. The color guard here at Damonte Ranch has been very successful the last 6 years since I've been here. We have pretty much built the program from the ground up. It was established here, but we took it to the next level from a national perspective. The last couple of years have been great. These kids have not only been successful outside of in the community, in the state of California, or even in the state of Ohio, but just in the school community itself. I believe they've gained respect just like the football team. They work as hard as the football team. Their level of commitment and their level of trying to pursue that excellence is second to none. They have a guard class where they do their stuff, they practice. So realistically, they, as far as I'm concerned, they practice more than a football team. It's not so much of trying to win nationals or anything, it's just more of how far can they take the program and how far can they take the show. From an emotional as well as, you know, that bond and that consistency of being great, right? Making sure that the audience connects with them. So it's pretty good. Our incoming freshmen will attend band camp, and then we use band season as a training ground for the winter season. That allows us to play around with different skills, putting people on different pieces of equipment. They can either learn how to spin rifle, saber, or flag. So we use band season not only as a complementary to the band, but we usually use that as a training ground. I usually don't allow anyone to do winter season without going through band season because they learn, I believe, pretty close to 75% of their leadership skills are learned through band season, and they also learn how to be vigilant as well as how to establish those work ethics that are going to help them during their winter season. So by the time they get to winter season, they're just excited, like that's their season. So once band season is over, I usually give them a month or so. We have the holidays, and we start on full swing right after New Year's Day. They go for an entire week, sometimes a week and a half, just getting their show done. And we also are very fortunate to have some great designers that come in and help with the process. So it's a long season for them. You know, they go from pretty much from August all the way through to second week of April. The team is made up of different heights. I do have, I'm very fortunate here that we have a great middle school program that feeds into Damonte, DePoli Middle School, and I have helped out in the past there, and then that allows the members to just get a feel of what it takes to get the rifle up in the air. And then once they get into the high school, we refine those skills. We try to make sure that they understand what does it take to get it up. And it's just not about counting, it's about counting those rotations, where do you stick your hand in there and stuff like that. So it takes a lot of practice. Again, these kids, I have been, for the most of them, I've been teaching them for 6 to 7 years from when they were in the middle school. So they understand what the process is, and they know what pretty much the trait to get that rifle and then for them to catch it, you know. But it's a challenge when you have kids that are different heights and you have different kids that have different experiences. This year in the weapon line, and when I say weapon line, I say rifle and saber, I have two freshmen and a sophomore in that line. Which is a first for Damonte. We've never had freshmen in the weapon line. And those kids are amazing. And they're kids that, yeah, they spun in the middle school, but when they came here, they just flourished. Some of the obstacles that we have in general here in Damonte Ranch and in Reno is that there isn't, compared to our competitors in California or even down in Southern Nevada, is that there's their circuit, and what I mean by circuit is their, you know, collective bodies of groups that compete, is very small here in Reno. So as a team that is going to nationals, we never really get the adjudication that helps us. So we really do rely on having a great design team, you know, that knows what they're doing, so that all we have to do is manage the program and get stuff done, but that the staff, it's easy for them, and all they have to do is work the show and clean the show. That's one of the obstacles. Two, it's not very easy to get out of Reno. The plane tickets are very expensive. And even though we manage, I've got great parents that will do anything to get the program to where they needs to be. And it's not so much winning or anything like that. It's just seeing their kid have an opportunity to perform on the national stage. Not many programs do that. So far for the season, we went out early and we won the regional and we were seeded pretty well. So we didn't know going into the Western Power Regional what was going to happen. Again, you look at a community that's very small and that is not very keen on that whole color guard activity. So to look at these kids and take them out of the state, whether it be to California or Ohio, and them just embrace the culture and be successful, I couldn't be any more proud of them. This year, this show is a little bit more on the emotional side. We deal with a lot of elements of friendships coming together and friendships coming apart. We do a lot of sign language in this year's show, just so that we can have this conversation, but not only with the performers, but with the audience, right? We wanna make sure that the audience is engaged in our process. So one of the challenges has been how do you get high school kids to be emotional and how do you get to do that? Yeah, sometimes you are very dramatic, but how do you get them to do that at a professional a professional and from an emotional standpoint. For the most part, it's starting to sink in. You know, they have the potential to be very successful next weekend. So it's, to get to this level and to be where they're at. You know, I coming in third at the Power Regional is fantastic. You know, out of 43 schools, I couldn't have asked for anything better than them. And there were some amazing schools at this regional. So, all I can ask for is that when we go to Dayton, next week is that the kids have fun and they remember their last performance and then have no regrets.
One day you and I will make it through this. We'll look back.